All right, hi team, welcome in to your Primal HIIT. So we've got a little bit of equipment that we're working with today. However, if you don't have any of this equipment, you can do it completely bodyweight style, and I'll just provide some alternative options for you if you're not using any dumbbells. So you can see I do have a box, or if you have a bench or a small stool, you may need that or want that for later for your Bulgarian split squats so that the back foot can be elevated. If you don't have that, no problem, I got another option for you. Then I've got two sets of dumbbells. I've got a heavy set at 20 pounds and then a light to medium set at 10 pounds. I also am bringing in a long loop band, so a resistance band just for the warm up, but you can go without. You can grab like a little stick, a broomstick, or even your smaller loop band, and I'll give you some other options there. So we're working today with three parts to our workout. The sequence is going to be the same, meaning the timing. It's a 3-to-1 work to rest ratio. Most of us know a Tabata style workout, which is 2-to-1. We're going 3-to-1. So for every 3 seconds of work, you have 1 second of rest. So I'll explain those drills and the work time later, but let's get warmed up, let's get moving, and then we start sweating. So you're gonna start standing with your feet wide, arms come right in front of the chest, and just little twists, keeping the feet and the hips quiet. So just working through some trunk twisters, activating the obliques, standing up nice and tall. Lengthen the spine, relax the shoulders down for 3, 2, last one, and then just start to swing the arms from side to side, right over left over right, and you can actually almost hug yourself as the arms come across the chest. You're getting a little bit of blood flow into the upper body, into the shoulders, and feeling the stretch through the chest as the arms open for 3, 2, 1, and then forward and back. Biceps next to the ears, arms up to the ceiling. Push them back, sweep them back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 3 big circles forward. And then 3 big circles back. We are gonna focus on some upper body today, so we'll definitely get that warmed up. And then just tap in and out, light jumping jacks. Starting to elevate the heart rate, breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth. You're gonna toe ball heel as you roll through your feet to land soft. Bend your knees slightly. Big motion of the arm, so not tiny and small. Really take up the space. 10, for 8, 7, 6, core tight. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. If you have a resistance band, you're gonna grab it. If you have like a broomstick or just something solid that you can grab, you're gonna open up the arms about shoulder distance, maybe a little bit wider, and then circle the arms forward, circle the arms back. So I'm bringing the band behind the body, keeping tension on the band, so I don't need it to be long and loose, just a little bit of tension. Waking up the shoulders, getting into the range of motion. Last 3, 2, last one. From here, you're gonna go palms up on your band. So if you have a smaller loop band, you're gonna place your hands into the band and take external rotation. We're gonna take the same thing here, but palms are up. You can go single loop, or if you've doubled it up, you have both parts of the band, it's gonna make it a little bit more challenging. Thumbs are gonna go out, elbows lock into your sides. You're working on rotating externally from the shoulder. Just 3, 4, 5, 5 more. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Now you're gonna flip the palms back over. Palms facing down towards the floor, roll the shoulders back and down. I'm gonna pull this band apart, keeping a tiny bend through the elbows, but I'm gonna lean and pull back, touch the band to the chest. If I turn to the side, core is tight, squeeze the glutes, squeeze the legs, and I'm not puffing the chest out to make that happen. We'll go 10 more. 10, 9, feeling that upper back start to engage. 7, wake it up. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, last one. Get rid of your band. You're gonna come to the top of your mat, reach your arms up on the inhale. As you exhale, push the hips back. So you're in a nice flat back hinge position. Inhale up, exhale, bend the knees, hips go back. 3, 2. Last one, reach the arms forward, separate the feet slightly, about shoulder distance apart. Roll the shoulders back and down, close the ribs, belly pulls in and up, drop the hips low, and push to stand. Down for 2, up for 2. Maybe you're not going that low, it might be here, about halfway. Hips go back and down, finding the depth of your squat, press the knees out. Slow control, shoulders back, tall spine. For 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, lower bottom portion of the squat, hands down, step back, high plank, and then downward facing dog. Just pedal the knees, drop the right heel, drop the left heel, hips are high, hands shoulder distance, feet hip width. For 3, for 2, last one, inhale, the right leg goes up and back. Exhale, step all the way outside your right hand. Dragon lunge, really, really big step. Right arm reaches up. As you exhale, drop the right elbow to the floor. 3 more. Twisting open through the spine, trying to stack the shoulders. Eyes follow the hand. Last one. Right palm goes down. You're gonna take the right leg back again. And this time exhale into your plank, knee towards your nose. Inhale, right leg up and back, downward dog. Exhale, pull through. 2 more, 3-legged. Tiger curl. Last one, 3-legged. Tiger curl and hold. Tiny pulse of the knee towards the nose for 10, 9, 8, lock in the core. Shoulders on top of the wrist for 4, 3, 2, 1. Downward facing dog. Left leg right away. Exhale, step it all the way outside the left hand. So it's a wider step. Right hand plants, left arm reach up. Inhale, exhale, slow it down. So this is allowing you to open up the hip and the shoulder comes inside the leg, inside the knee. 2 more. Last one, twist open. Exhale, drop. Left palm down. Use the core to pull up and in and take the left leg back, hips high. Right heel is heavy. Exhale, knee towards the nose, tiger curl. 3 more. Strong through the arms, through the shoulders. Fingertips spread wide and hips are square. Last one, pull forward, hold, tiny pulse. Lift the belly, lift the knee for 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Downward facing dog. Drop both knees to the floor. So we're gonna talk about our beast position, our loaded beast, and our crab position, because all of that, since this is a primal HIIT, is gonna be present today with our within the workout. So your beast position, shoulders, elbows, wrists, right there, stack it. Knees are underneath the hips, tuck your toes. You have a flat back, so we don't wanna round, and we also don't wanna drop the belly, so just a neutral, natural curve of the spine, but belly pulled in, squeeze the glutes, tuck the toes, hover the knees, and then just tap. So you're finding the engagement in this position, long back of the neck, shoulders into the back body for 10, 9, and the core is what's lowering and lifting, not the hips, right? Not like this, no twerking, not here. You got 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, lower your knees, but open them slightly. You're gonna push the hips back towards your heel. So this is a modified loaded beast, and then walk the arms forward. We're working in an extended position for the shoulder and building strength there. So the shoulder's not necessarily like tightly packed into the back. We actually wanna push as if we were pressing a weight, and you feel the lat and the shoulder move in that position. So now the arms are forward, hands are strong. Tuck the toes under if they're not there. You're gonna hover the knees and drop. Core tight, lift, lower. 3 more, lift, lower. 2, lift, lower. Last one, lift, hold. Knees are 1 to 2 inches off the floor. You're gonna push the hips further back, arms pressing forward. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, release. Drop both knees, swing your legs out in front. a little bit of core, and then we go into our crab. Reach the arms forward, take a big inhale, exhale, roll down nice and slow. Hands go to the tops of the thighs. Take another inhale. As you exhale, head and shoulders lift, press the lower back down, pull belly in and up. So you're bringing the navel in towards the spine, but it's not enough just to pull the belly down and press the back into the floor. You have to pull all of those abdominal muscles and your organs up towards the heart for 10, 9, 8. Open through the chest, shoulders down for 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold here, hands behind the head, both legs to tabletop, right toe, left toe. Alternating toe taps. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Keep the hips anchored, head and shoulders lifted. Modification, drop it to the floor. Elbows wide, and then feel the shoulders into the back. Sometimes creeps up, we think we're working, pull it down. For 5, 4, 3, 2, hold here, both legs and table, arms forward, lift, lift. So it's almost like you're trying to tap your fingertips together behind your hips. Shoulders stay off the floor. Use the exhale, lift and pulse a little bit higher. Last 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Rock and roll up. Core is ready. It's engaged, warmed up. Setting up for your crab position. Hands back behind you. Palms on the floor, fingertips face away from your hips. So you have external rotation through the shoulder, and then you can really open up the chest. Feet about hip width, planted. You're gonna slide the hips forward and back between the heels and the palms, the wrists. Now we wanna find equal distance between those two points, or those four points, and that's where the hips are gonna live. Open up the chest, lift and tap. Lift, just a small lift. Think about opening up through the front of the body. Sometimes we like to curl under. You're looking to open that space up. 3, 2, last one, hold the hips up. Pull the right elbow in. Switch, left elbow. 2 more times like that, right elbow. Left elbow, keep the proud chest, shoulders open. Right elbow pulls in, now we send the hips up. You only reach back if your hips are all the way up. If you're here, that's as high as you go. You don't extend the arm. Hips all the way up. You can trace with the eyes. Follow the hand. Look towards the bottom. Corkscrew as if you're opening a door. And then return. Switch. Right palm down. Left elbow in. Hips up first. Now I have open through the chest. I'm gonna stack the left shoulder on top of the right, so it's not a back bend. I'm gonna stack, it's a little bit of a rotation. As I follow, frame the head, look towards the floor, corkscrew the bottom hand, and then return. We'll go one more time, a little bit faster either side. Right elbow in, hips up, trace, stack the shoulders, pull back, return, hover the hips. Right hand down, left elbow up, hips up, trace. Pull it back, lower, release. All right, grab the backs of the thighs. You got 4 rock and rolls. Just rolling to the shoulders. Last one, use the momentum. Stand up, twist it out. Stay light on the feet. Now I'm gonna explain our first block. You have 3 parts to it. We have a 30 seconds of work, 10 seconds rest, 60 seconds work, 20 seconds rest, 90 second work, 30 second rest. We're gonna do that for 3 rounds before we move on to our next block. So.